Good morning. Welcome to this celebration of the Eucharist on the Feast of the Epiphany. If you have a cell phone with you today, please silence it now or turn it off. We do not want to disturb the sacredness of the liturgy. Just a friendly reminder, in light of the many cautionary directives due to the outbreak of the coronavirus, Bishop Rice has asked us to suspend our greeting at the beginning of Mass. The sign of peace will also be discontinued until further notice. Please remember that you are highly encouraged to wear your face mask during Mass. Our celebrant today is Father Rick Jones, our pastor, and is being assisted by Deacon Mark Kiblinger. As we begin the celebration, let's pray together by singing As With Gladness, found in your bulletin.
As with gladness men of old did the guiding star behold, as with joy they hailed its light, leading onward beaming bright, so most gracious Lord, may we evermore your splendor see. As with joyful steps they sped to that lowly manger bed, there to bend the knee before him whom heaven and earth adore. So may we with hurried pace run to seek your throne of grace. As they offered gifts most rare at that manger crude and bare, so may we this holy day, drawn to you without delay, all our costliest treasures bring, Christ to you, our heavenly King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Happy Epiphany to all of you. Merry Christmas to all of you. You got to stay up here, okay? Had a lot of coffee before the 7:30 and still kicking in, so I'm going to jet to heaven, and so are the rest of us. We're just like the wise men. We come here and we find heaven on earth. We find heaven joining with us in the child Jesus being born among us. And so all of us, we have this journey that we're on, and it's to find the Lord, our Emmanuel, our God with us. So let's prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries, calling to mind our need for the Lord.
Lord Jesus, you are light shining in the darkness. Drive away the darkness of our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, the Magi went to seek and they found you. Help us in our journey to encounter you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, help us to use the gifts and talents entrusted to us to build the kingdom of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Praise you. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you, the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Judgment to the king, to a king's son, your justice. that he may judge your people in justice and your poor in right judgment.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
In his days shall justice flourish, and great peace till the moon is no more. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the river to the bounds of the earth.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
The kings of Tarshish and the islands shall pay him tribute. The kings of Sheba and Seba shall bring him gifts. Before him all kings shall fall prostrate, all nations shall serve him.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
For he shall save the needy when they cry, the poor and those who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and the needy, and save the lives of the needy.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise of Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. His holy people, Father,
alleluia,
Son, and
Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. We saw a star at its rising and have come to do him homage. Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it had been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures. They offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Well, once again, to all of you, happy feast day of Christmas and happy feast day of the Epiphany. To all of you who are gathered here and to anyone who may be with us via our live stream, we want to welcome you and to wish you the same, to wish blessings upon you and all of our families, all of our families that are gathered here, families that are parishioners here, and if there's any guests, we want to welcome you in a special way too, to ask God's special blessing on you, that you might be renewed by these sacred mysteries that we celebrate. We have today, on this Epiphany, the shepherds to bless us as a part of our families. We have the three wise men to bless us as a part of our family. And we have the great example of the Holy Family to bless us. And the Holy Family, like we celebrated last Sunday on the Feast of the Holy Family, that includes Saint Joseph, Saint Mary, and the baby Jesus. But on this feast day of Epiphany, the Holy Family grows. It grows into a large worldwide community, more than just the Holy Family like we normally think about it, baby Jesus, Joseph, and Mary. The Holy Family grows into this worldwide community where we see how everyone belongs to the family of Jesus and how every family wants to see this newborn Emmanuel. Everyone wants to come to this Emmanuel who has come into our world. Emmanuel who has come to be born not just in a manger, like we remember 2,000 years ago, but Emmanuel who wants to be born in our hearts and in our lives. That's where Emmanuel, Jesus, really wants to live. He wants to live in our hearts, in our lives. He wants to live being born again into our families, into our towns, into our country, into our world. Emmanuel comes to be born in us. Like that first Christmas, heaven still meets earth. And it happens within us. Think of that first Christmas. What happened? Mary said yes to the word of God. 9 months later, she gave birth to this baby child, this baby boy, and he was the incarnate word of God made flesh. Heaven come down to earth. And that still happens, but it happens within our flesh. Heaven still meets earth. Heaven touches our families. And even if you think your family is imperfect, even if you think your family is broken, the Holy Family especially wants to be with you and your family. The example of Saint Joseph and Saint Mary urges all parents today. In fact, I think encourages all grandparents, and I think it encourages all aunts and uncles. It encourages everyone in families to put their families in God's hands, to trust in God as they did. You know, I think of that first Christmas, and do you think it was easy for Mary and Joseph to trust in God's plan? I mean, first of all, it was probably difficult just to say, okay, the incarnate word of God is going to become in flesh in our family. Joseph and Mary probably had a tough time with that. And then we see about how these shepherds, these smelly shepherds, came in from the fields saying that they had heard voices of angels and how they had come to adore the Christ child, and they had found Joseph and Mary. Do you think it was easy for them to open the doors to those shepherds? Probably very difficult. But they trusted. But they trusted. And then these magi, these three magi, these wise men, you know, from the east, they come. Do you think it was easy for them to open the doors to let these magi in? I mean, who were they? They probably didn't look really like Joseph and Mary. They probably looked a little different. They might have been, appeared to be very, very rich, you know, coming in on their big camels, loaded with all of their stuff. Mary and Joseph was probably, they're probably wondering, well, how long are they going to stay, you know? But they trusted. They trusted, you know? They trusted in God. And I think all of us in our families, whatever our family might look like, all of us, single or married, are to put ourselves in God's hands. In so doing, God's grace helps us realize who we are and what we are called to become. Holy people in holy families. Holy people in holy families. I said this last week, if you were at any of my masses, you've heard me say this, but I'm going to say it again because I haven't had this mass in this new year. I still have hope that in our holy family here at St. Vincent de Paul, that we will soon have some religious vocations to go along with all of the holy families that we have in our parish who have celebrated the sacrament of matrimony. We've got a lot of holy families right here. You've all celebrated the sacrament of matrimony. Those of you who have made a commitment to be together in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, forever and ever. I still have hope that soon and very soon we're going to have some religious vocations to go along with our holy families here in our parish. I said this last weekend, I'll say it again, we have one young man, David Kiblinger, who has answered the call to religious life. We can still claim David. He's the son of Debbie and Deacon Mark Kiblinger. David is a Jesuit, a member of the Society of Jesus, the same community that Pope Francis is a member. That's one religious vocation that we can claim from our parish. A few years ago, we had a young man by the name of Joseph Stoverick. Joseph was from our parish, and we could claim him. But he got ordained, and he's off doing his own thing, living in another parish, doing the work of God. So we can't claim him. He's not in our care anymore. We've given him to the church, okay? Soon, we're going to give David to the church. He's going to be ordained a deacon, God willing, and then a priest, God willing. And you know what happens then? We won't be able to claim him. We'll be back to zero Zero. Zero. The largest parish on this side of the diocese, and we're going to have zero. St. Elizabeth Ann Seton, the parish where Father Brian came from, they have three vocations, three young men in the seminary. Just a little bit bigger than we are. Three young men in the seminary. A parish our size should have at least, I believe, five religious vocations. I'd personally like a mix of maybe three and three. Three young men in the seminary and three young women in the convent. I know that adds up to six. But if we're going to do it, let's be extravagant, okay? Let's be extravagant in our gift to God. Just like the wise men were when they came to the baby Jesus. They were extravagant in their gifts that they gave to baby Jesus. Do you think that the gifts that they brought, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, were just like something they found in the corner of their house and they said, oh, well, let's take this, you know, or let's what do they call that when you get a gift and you give it away again? You re-gift it. You think they just like, oh, well, let's re-gift this to baby Jesus. They took probably what was a lifetime of work and they gave it to God. They gave it to baby Jesus. A lifetime of work and they gave it to God. I think the wise men, they represent how we're called to be extravagant in our gift to God as well. I asked a year or so ago that on our first Fridays, when we have adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, like we're going to be having this coming Friday, that our first prayer to the Lord would be for good vocations from our holy families here at St. Vincent's, to continue to strengthen our good married vocations that we have, but then also to see about maybe how we can have some religious vocations come from our families. You know, religious vocations, they come from families that have struggles and hurts. So if you think your family has to be all that holy to have a sister or priest come from it, you know, I'd like you just to kind of flush that idea down the drain, just to get rid of it. Because, you know, it's not that way. Vocations, all vocations, they come from just ordinary families. And sometimes, like I say, with lots of hurts in them. Do you think St. Joseph was that holy of a man? Think St. Joseph was that holy of a man? He had a lot going for him, but he was just probably ordinary, just like each and every one of us. Which shows us how we too can be holy like he was. He had a normal job, and yet he was called to bring the Christ child to others. Were the shepherds very holy? Probably not, from what history tells us of the tradition of those who were shepherds, that they were kind of out in the field doing their own thing, not really able to keep the Sabbath holy, so they were considered maybe not so holy at all. What about those wise men? Those wise men, do you think they were so holy? Probably not. Probably not. They might have been considered crazy guys on a goose chase. Long after the wise men would have left, St. Paul would have probably thought of them when in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 10, St. Paul calls all of us to be fools for Christ. Fools for Christ. And indeed, that's what we are called to be. That's what they were, the wise men, and that's what we're called to be as well. And I think every priest that I know, every religious sister, every religious brother, and to a certain extent, permanent deacons, but, you know, they have their wives to ground them in the reality of the world. I think all of us are fools for Christ. Every religious vocation brings Jesus to others. St. Joseph and the others at the crib answered the call to ministry. And so today, as we think of this Epiphany,
this light that comes into our lives to maybe light up that area of what we are called to be and where we are called to go. What about us? Can that light open up something new in us? Can that light illuminate something of our vocation? What about our families? Can we encourage someone to become a priest, or a religious sister, or a religious brother, or a permanent deacon? In this special year of St. Joseph, may God touch the hearts of those who are discerning the possibility of a religious vocation throughout the whole world, but especially from our parish. May the saints of old continue to guide us. May they also allow this light of Epiphany to come into our lives to illuminate where we are called to be, and to allow the holy men and women who have gone before us to show us the way, to give us some direction, so that we can always remind ourselves that we have help in our discernment. We have hope in our call. So today we cry out, Saint Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Grandparents of Jesus, Saint Anne and Saint Joachim. Cousins of Jesus, cousin of Jesus, Saint John the Baptist. Aunt and uncle of Jesus, Saint Elizabeth and Saint Zachariah. Holy angels of God. Simple shepherds of Bethlehem. Wise men called to adore. All holy men and women. As disciples of the Lord, let's together profess what it is that we believe in. I believe in one God. Let us now bring to the Lord our gifts of prayer and praise.
For the church, may she welcome the poor, the sick, the stranger, and the sinner as Christ welcomed them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all national and local authorities, may they recognize an authority far greater than their own. Let us pray to the Lord. For intellectuals, scientists, and all seekers of truth, may they follow the star and find Christ, the light of the world. Let us pray to the Lord. for those who have coffers filled with gold and other forms of material wealth, may they share their resources with the poor and disenfranchised. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For people in the midst of discerning their futures, especially young adults, may they have the courage to consult God's wisdom and to follow divine providence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the faithful departed. May they experience the peace and joy of the heavenly kingdom today and forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Today we pray for the St. Vincent de Paul Parish family for whom this Mass is offered and for the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we continue to pray for the healing of Alex Powderly, a 16-year-old parishioner of ours, son of Tim and Lori Powderly. Alex was found to have a tumor that was growing on his spine this past week before Christmas, and so we want to pray for his doctors and nurses that they'll be able to take care of him and he'll be able to resume his former duties with no difficulty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the repose of the soul of one of our diocesan priests who died yesterday morning, for Monsignor Raymond Orff, for his soul that he may rest in peace, we pray to the Lord. Lord God, just as the Magi were drawn to your Son by the light of a star, so you draw all creation to yourself by the truth of the gospel. May the powers of this world bow down before you in humility and in awe. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet? Shepherds, God, and angels sing.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice at your hands. Praise and glory to his name. Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which are now offered not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but the one by them who is proclaimed sacrifice and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when Jesus appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and he breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, with the whole order of bishops, all the priests, the deacons, the religious, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to service of the gospel. Keep us always attentive to the needs of others, so that sharing their grief and their pain, their joy and their hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember all of our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Saint Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, with our patron saints, especially Saint Vincent, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, Lord, but see rather the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof. Say the word and my soul. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Westward leading.
stone cold tomb. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to the perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, sounds through the earth and skies. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to the perfect light.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, so that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. We ask this as we ask all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements before we go our way the rest of this Sunday. Catholic Man Night will be held at 6:30 p.m. tomorrow night on Monday evening at Immaculate Conception Parish in Jackson, and it will include an evening of adoration, confession, and a socially distanced manly meal. I don't know how that's going to work, a socially distanced manly meal. We'll also see about that. Or maybe we just won't. Maybe we'll just come home right after. That's what I normally do. I usually go, I go to adoration, I go to confession, and I'm out of there. So those manly meals, let me tell you, they can do you in after a while. Especially a socially distanced manly meal. I'll give it an option. Maybe I'll listen to see what they have. I don't know. Are you gonna go?
I am gonna go.
You gonna go to the socially distanced manly meal?
Yes, sir. Yes, Father.
What is it gonna be? Do you know?
I don't know.
You don't know, okay. Deacon Tom, you gonna go?
No.
No? Okay. Deacon Rob, you gonna go? Okay, okay, very good. This, I tell you, there's the convergence of the deacons today. We're blessed to have all the deacons with us. PSR returns at 6 p.m. this Wednesday in the church. The family topic is Epiphany. So we'll be talking about Epiphany and the beauty of how the many gifts that we're given through the church. So In addition to the PSR families, all members of the parish are invited. ID Cape will host their monthly Disciples Night this Thursday at 6:15 in the Old Convent. And then Adoration of the Eucharist will take place this Friday after the 6:30 Mass and end with benediction at 5:15. That was postponed from last Friday because it was a holiday. So we're doing our first Friday adoration on this coming Friday, January the 8th. And we'll need some volunteers to help sanitize the pews. And then don't forget about the Magi. The Magi, the wise men, brought books for all of us in the parish. Dynamic Catholic has offered a special book for many parishes, and we got the one that has a daily thought and reflection by Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta. So those are out in the gathering space for you. Feel free to take one for you, and also feel free to take one for maybe a member of our parish that can't be here, or maybe another homebound family member that you know of, okay? We have plenty of them out there. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Songs of thankfulness and praise, Jesus, Lord, to you we raise. Manifested by the star to the sages from afar, branch of royal David's stem, in your birth at Bethlehem, anthems be to you addressed, God in flesh.